Well, the future of Maryland horse racing and the Preakness Stakes in particular is a subject of high-level talks in Annapolis. The governor's office called a meeting with track owners and representatives of the horse racing community to come up with ideas on how to save the industry. I-Team reporter David Collins is live at the State House with the very latest. David?
Kai, the meeting just ended. It lasted more than 3 hours. We're told there is universal agreement that the Preakness must be held. However, nothing is resolved.
I'm glad you could be here on short order. I know some of you had to cancel plans, and, you know, I feel bad about that, but this is certainly a timely and important issue.
The governor called all horse racing stakeholders to a roundtable discussion of the future of the industry. The goal is to broker a deal to salvage live racing next year and ensure the future of the Preakness.
What's the difference if we're dead?
Last week, the Maryland Racing Commission rejected a proposal to cut the season to just 47 days between Laurel and Pimlico. The move not only jeopardizes the Preakness, but could put some 10,000 jobs associated with racing at risk. The track owners want more of the slot's proceeds for operating expenses. This may be accomplished through legislation. State law allows up to $40 million a year for track improvement, but these are matching dollars. A state takeover of the tracks is not considered a real option at this point. Persuading the owners to sell is also considered unrealistic. Horsemen suggest using some of the purse money to temporarily prop up live racing days until a more permanent solution is found. The state's only operating slots parlor, the Hollywood Casino in Perryville, generated $7.6 million in revenues for November. This is slightly lower than October's take. According to state lottery officials, so far the casino has made $21 million since its September 27th opening. After Ocean Down Slots is in full swing, the purse account is expected to grow to at least $12 million. Horsemen say, what's the point of having a big purse if there are no races?
According to one of the governor's top aides, there's no appetite, at least in the O'Malley administration, to change the slot splits to give the track owners more capital improvement money. All the stakeholders have agreed to meet either later this week or early next week to try to resolve the racing schedule issue.